Hey guys, thanks for joining me on Playing with Rain. Today I have a really fun experiment I want to show you. This is involving supercooled water and how to turn supercooled water, which is below the freezing mark but still a liquid, into ice instantly. This is something I learned when I was actually a kid on a camping trip. I pulled a ice cold bottle of water out of an ice chest and it was liquid. And the next thing I know, I looked at it and it was actually a slushy kind of ice mixture inside. And what happened was I shook that up a little bit as I pulled it out and it froze instantly. It needed something to kind of kickstart that freezing point. So I have four bottles of water right here and I have them in kind of a, what I call a salt, icy salt bath. I put a bowl filled with ice. I used some rock salt and then again, some bottled water, purified water you can buy at the store, works great for this. And then I put in some food coloring before I actually started cooling it down. Wanted to make sure I put the food coloring in first, not after it gets to the right temperature, because then you run the risk of having that ice form in the bottle before you want it to. Also, I have a thermometer here, just a cooking or a baking thermometer that should do the trick. This is a pretty simple one. I know there's other ones you can get that are digital that might work just as great or better, but you're going to want to put this thermometer down into the ice pretty close to where your bottles are, and you're going to want to kind of watch that drop. Now, ideally, you want it to get to around 17, 18 degrees for that icy kind of salt water combination. What the salt does when you add to this is it drops the freezing point down below that 32 degree mark. So you start to see the ice actually melting, but it's melting at a temperature below freezing and you're getting more of that water that's going to cover more of the surface area at the bottom of your bottles to help to cool it down faster. I've had this sitting like this for about an hour, hour and a half now. And I think it's pretty close to being at the right temperature, so we're gonna go ahead and try that. The other materials you're going to need is just a pan here, kind of a, you can buy these aluminum pans at a store for pretty cheap. I filled it with about an inch of water, put it in the freezer, and I froze it to ice, so we have kind of a nice icy platform that we're going to use to create this ice rainbow here in just a little bit. And then I have a plate that, again, has some ice on it too, very similar. I'm gonna demonstrate with the plate first so you can see it a little bit better. And then you're going to want to do this with the rock salt and the ice, putting the bottles in there, and you just want to watch your temperature for, it can take anywhere from about 45 minutes to an hour, hour and a half for these to get to the right temperature and get down below that 20 degree mark, ideally to where it's super cooled, but it hasn't turned to ice yet. You can try this in a freezer as well. I've done it in the freezer before, but it is a little bit trickier because freezers vary on the make and the model of the freezer and how cold they are. So getting that timing just right, it can vary anywhere from an hour and a half to 4 hours before it's ready in the freezer. And it's a lot harder to get it at the right threshold. I did mine in the freezer this morning a couple times, and by the time I checked it, it was already forming ice. It was past that point of super cooled and still liquid. So I have found that this is kind of the easiest method to do it. Another easy way to tell if you don't have a thermometer, notice, if it's probably hard to see on the camera, but there's some ice that has formed on the outside of the bottles, of these water bottles. There's a little bit of condensation that started to build up. It was just some liquid condensation on the outside of the water bottles. But now some of that condensation has started to freeze over to some ice and some frost. That tells me that those bottles inside are below 32 degrees. The water inside there is, even though it's still a liquid formation. So I'm gonna pull this one out of our ice right here. And just for demonstration purposes, we'll use this one here that you might be able to see a little bit better. So this is just a plate with a little bit of ice on it. I put in the freezer with some water and had that water freeze to ice before this. I'm going to open this very carefully. You don't want to disturb it because that'll kind of give those water molecules a little bit of that energy boost they need to kind of nucleate, is what it's called, and turn into ice crystals. So we don't want to do that just yet. What I do want to do is I want to pour it onto this plate of ice, and we're going to see if we can build an ice castle here, or an ice pillar. See what's happening? Look at that. It's working. Isn't that so cool? Oh my goodness, there it is. So that is basically what we're going to do, but we're going to take it to the next level, and because this doesn't hold as much water, and I've about filled that plate with water, we're going to move over here and do it in our bigger tray. And we're gonna do it with these different colors. So let's see what the red one here does. We're gonna pour this on. very quickly. And if you look really close, you kind of have to time it just right. If you go kind of slow, it has a better time forming those ice crystals. So that ice is instantly crystallizing. Can you see that tower that we've built with that? Let's try the green and see what the green does. We're going to try it right here in the middle. And I think I went a little bit fast with the red one. Now that I'm going slower with this green one, it's having an easier time crystallizing that ice and forming. And there you have a green tower. Oh, my green one might fall. Oh, it's going to fall. It's going to fall. There we go. So the green one tipped over and fell. Let's try the blue one and see if we can keep it standing just a little bit longer. There we go. We've got a little bit of a start of an ice tower or pillar, whatever you want to call it. And it's getting pretty tall. Maybe should I stop there so it doesn't fall? Or, oh, it's about to fall anyway, so I'm going to keep growing it. Here we go. We're going to grow this just a little bigger. Wow. Holy cow, that is awesome. I got it pretty big. Bigger than I've ever actually been able to get these, as high as I've been able to get them. So that is just so cool. I love doing this experiment. One of the funnest ones that I've done yet, actually. And it's really cool. You can look at the water now underneath there, and you've got those different colors of the red, the green, and the blue mixed in. And my blue tower is about to fall. Look at that. It's starting to go, and it just tipped. So it doesn't last very long. But just so much fun to show how the process works of supercooling water. This experiment can actually be used to explain the science behind why we get freezing rain sometimes during the winter times, especially areas out in the plains in the Midwest, where you get a warm front with a cold front moving in. You get warm air in the upper levels of the atmosphere that slides over that colder air at the surface. And what happens is, you may have rain or you might have snow falling at the top of those clouds, and then as it falls through the warmer levels of the atmosphere, it starts to melt back to water droplets. But then there's sometimes a shallow, real thin layer of cold air at the surface of the earth, and that's below freezing, and those water droplets then fall back through that. They drop below freezing, but they don't have enough time to freeze back to ice, and they fall, they contact the ground as water droplets that are super cooled below freezing, and anything they contact that's below freezing, they instantly freeze. That's kind of what happens here. It's a process called nucleation, ice nucleation. And so you wanna use water that's pure so that you can make sure that it doesn't have anything that's going to help to kind of spark off that nucleation. And then as soon as you pour it onto either this frozen piece of ice or you can pour it onto other ice cubes, that kind of kickstarts that process of the ice crystals forming. The water molecules are able to form into ice crystals and start building upon each other. So something really cool, really fun that I love to do. I hope you guys had some fun doing that. This is something you can do with your kids that's super fun. You will want to kind of supervise a little bit just if you're using the food coloring especially so they don't make too much of a mess. But really a fun time. I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did enjoy this, if you like all of our other experiments, please don't forget to subscribe, hit that subscribe button so that you won't miss any of the fun that we have coming your way over the next little while as well. Thanks, guys. So I've built a little bit of an ice pillar. It's about to fall, but I'm gonna add a little more. Oh, there we go. Okay.